Hi.
Hi.
I'm Jesus Torres, EarthDance apprentice, first year.
I'm Molly, director of EarthDance.
And this is what's in our CSA box today.
For week 12.
Week 12. For me, it's the peppers are finally in.
Yes.
And I love these cuerno de toro. It's a sweet pepper. We also have...
Do you know that means horn of the bull?
Absolutely, yeah.
You can translate that better
than I
can.
That's what my people call it. And we also have a traditional bell pepper. It's also, they're both taste similar. They're sweet peppers in that family.
Mm-hmm. And this variety is called Ico Ico, and it turns many different colors.
Again, my people call it Ico Ico.
It's a pepper of many colors.
Yes. And then we have the dangerous habanero.
No.
It's not a habanero?
No, that's...
It looks like it's spicy.
No, it's not a habanero. It's too big. It's a poblano.
Poblano. All right. It looks like a habanero.
Yes.
And on
it
steroids.
Looks like a habanero on steroids.
On steroids, yeah. That's what threw me.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have some hot ones.
This one's actually sweet.
Is it?
Yeah.
It would also fall.
It looks like a hot one, but this is called Jimmy Nardello. It's an Italian variety. It's a sweet pepper that's really delicious fried.
Did not know that.
And then you said this one, right?
Yeah. Well, it's hot.
The jalapeno.
Then we have our onions and scallions along with our tomatoes.
You know what I was just reading about tomatoes?
What's that?
That lycopene, which is the substance that makes tomatoes red, helps protect against prostate cancer.
Really? Mm-hmm. And a person my age, we need to worry about that. So we have just your slicing tomato.
Yep.
And then we have a beautiful heirloom tomato.
Yes. Well, this is an heirloom too. This is a little bit, it's deceiving that it's an heirloom because it just looks so round and red. You don't think of these. This is a Moskvich is the variety. And Cherokee Purple is this variety.
Oh, wow. And this is interesting. I have never seen anything like this.
Have you had it yet?
No.
It's called, you know what it's called? Green Zebra.
Green Zebra.
Yeah, kind of like it looks. But the yellowish part, it's kind of like almost an orangey yellow and green stripes. That's how it's supposed to look. It's perfectly ripe just like this.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have a plethora or a cornucopia of our different smaller tomatoes. This is a cherry tomato. Your red tomato as well. And your beautiful sun golds.
Yeah, this one's called black cherry.
Black cherry.
Mm-hmm.
And they all have a unique flavor that just a taste explosion in your mouth. They're just awesome.
Ruby even likes them.
And if you add the scallions, the scallions, I don't know if this is a particular variety, but scallions and the garlic, and to me, you have the makings of the perfect salsa.
Oh,
you know,
cilantro. Snap.
Yeah.
You know, you should come to the farmer's market and buy some cilantro. Or maybe you have it still in your fridge from last week.
Yeah, that would be perfect. And this is, I mean, you got a little bit of savory with the poblano and the jalapeno.
Yeah.
And then you have some sweet stuff. So this is like the holy trilogy of,
yes,
of the start
really
of an awesome salsa.
Excited about salsa. Yeah. So let's not forget the green stuff. So I'm going to go over what else we've got in our share. We have got some lettuce. Oh my goodness. So it's so exciting to have lettuce in the summertime. Usually that's reserved for cooler months. Well, of course, we've had a cool summer. And our farmers have been so smart to put shade cloth over one of the beds so that the lettuce wouldn't bolt or get bitter. So we've got some delicious lettuce greens. We've also got some Malabar spinach. How have you been eating the Malabar spinach?
Oh, they are great on an omelet or in a frittata.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I just love sauteing it and adding it to my eggs, and it's just wonderful. In addition, that is, if you haven't seen the Malabar spinach plant, it is just a beautiful vining plant that I think everybody should have at their home.
Yeah.
Just an awesome, it's an awesome looking plant, and it's good tasting as well.
Actually, Rachel made our staff lunch yesterday, and she made BLTs and used the Malabar spinach because we didn't have lettuce, but now you could make BLST.
BLST.
With the tomatoes and the spinach and lettuce. And then, of course, we've got zephyr squash and zucchini. And you might be getting sick of this by now, so let me give you a little cooking tip. I was so excited to discover a new way I'd never cooked with it before. I just shredded it in the food processor and then kind of like salted it and got a little of the water content out of it to dry it up a little bit. And then I sauteed it with some taco seasoning mix. And I used it in place of ground beef or any other meat for taco filling. And then we have all of the other delicious toppings that you can just slice up raw and use for tacos.
Well, the thing, this is my favorite part of the year when it's regarding squash and zucchini, because, you know, we make zucchini bread with sorts of different stuff in it, you know, from chocolate chips to walnuts and everything. I mean, that to me is the best. But this weekend, what I did with last week's squash and zucchini, I put it on the grill.
Oh, there you go.
Just brushed them with olive oil, and the taste was wonderful.
You don't even have to do anything to it.
Yeah, and you put it on, I mean, there's no thinking about it. A little bit of olive oil, a little bit of salt on the grill, and you got a great dish.
Mm-hmm. And then last but not least, actually basil and purple potatoes. This variety is actually purple fleshed, and it is absolutely beautiful inside. I really like to have guests over when I'm cooking purple potatoes, just something a little out of the ordinary. And then, did you already mention the garlic?
I did with my salsa.
Oh yeah.
But the thing that I love eating this time of year are grilled cheese sandwiches with tomato and basil.
Oh.
I tried them for the first. First Tower Grove Market.
Oh yeah,
and it was delicious, and I'm kind of hooked. I mean, because you have the best of the summer, what I think.
Yeah.
You know, the cheese, the tomato, the basil. Mm-hmm. It is just, you know, it's a jolt to your entire senses.
Yeah. So one last thing I just want to point out that's pretty cool about this week's CSA share in particular. So you've got 12 different crops, right? We've got represented here. But out of these 12 crops, there's actually 20 different varieties. So we've got a lettuce variety, Malabar spinach, zephyr squash, Plato zucchini, purple potatoes, they have a more fancy name, I forget, basil, garlic, red onions, scallions. And then when you start counting the varieties and the peppers and tomatoes, it's amazing. We've got the Cherokee purple, green zebra, Moskvich, black cherry, cherry tomato, sun gold, Ico, Corno del Toro, poblano, jalapeno, Jimmy Nardello. That is 20 varieties. Talk about biodiversity on your table.
Yeah, I mean, it is just, it's awesome just trying all the different things that are grown here at the farm. Yeah.
We hope you enjoy your share as much as we do.